Millwall will be playing championship football for the first time in 4 years next season. Kenny Jackett's side beat Swindon 1-0 in the League One playoff final. Once again, though, there was controversy over the state of the Wembley pitch.
Millwall's championship hopes went up in smoke at Wembley last year, so they started this time around full of determination not to repeat the experience. This chip from Steve Morrison, one of several early Millwall chances. Then, after half an hour, offside was the verdict before Kevin Amankwa headed into his own net. Then Millwall did score. A Danny Schofield corner finished from close range by Paul Robinson.
He's in the right place, right time. Gets luck. That's not luck. Still has to finish it.
Halfway through the second half, Swindon looks certain to equalise.
Oh, mistake by Robinson. Austin, big moment here for Swindon. Oh, and he's missed it.
They couldn't believe it, neither could he, but did the much maligned Wembley pitch play a part?
Makes his mind up, and then look at that, just jump up, and it does hit his shin.
Morrison could have eased Millwall's tension with 8 minutes to go. Then with 30 seconds to go, Swindon had the final chance of the game.
Austin! Oh, the goalkeeper just about! Millwall are promoted!
Millwall at last win a playoff. It's the championship for them, and the last 15 sides promoted via the playoffs have stayed up. Gary Cottrell, Sky Sports.
We've had a good couple of seasons, you know, very good. So it's great to finish it off this way. I'm really pleased for everybody at the club. It's been an excellent decision to push on this year. And, you know, we've consciously made it, but now we've got to enjoy this. Look forward quickly, because we want to go in the next league and compete.
Had one or two little anxious moments right at the end there, didn't you?
Yeah, fair play to Swindon. Particularly at the start of the second half, they played really well and came at us. The keeper was strong on one or two crosses when he needed to be, but great feeling.
How proud are you to be the manager of the first Millwall team to come here to Wembley and win?
Yeah, they've been hitting us with that. I don't think we've been very good in playoff games so far, so if you keep persevering, you get there.
And how fitting is it that it should be Paul Robinson, of all people, to get the goal?
Yeah, good goal and big contribution. Been a really good player for us this year.
You've never managed in the Championship. How much are you looking forward to that challenge?
I've got to say, I've worked hard for it, so I'm looking forward to it. I really am.
No more than Millwall deserve this, is it, really?
No, definitely. We've had a good couple of years, and finishing third, you know, it's justice done.
You know, they're the first half. We've had the second half. It's just gone between us missing the header from a corner and a bobble on Charlie when he goes through on the keeper. So it's really hinged on those two moments, I suppose.
That was the key moment for you in the second half, wasn't it? Charlie Austin's effort. And were you aware of the bobble at the time?
You could see straight away, yeah. I've not seen it yet on TV, but I presume it was. It looked like it just bobbled up on him, you know, and I feel gutty for young Charlie, because he's taken it to heart, and it's not down to him. It's not down to him at all. It's possibly down to him we're here, you know, in the first place. So that's a fantastic season he's had. Yeah, but what I say, when you get here, you try and finish it off, and unfortunately we've not done it today.
So disappointed Danny Wilson, but for Millwall, they've been promoted, and I'm sure Rob Dorset, who's live at Wembley for us now, the celebrations will go long into the night.
Yeah, they will indeed, yeah. It looks pretty quiet and serene, doesn't it, inside the stadium here at Wembley. The fans have all gone home, but I tell you, it is not quiet in that Millwall changing room. We've got a couple of the heroes from today. We've got Danny Schofield and Darren Ward with us. And look, Danny Schofield's got the trophy as well. How special does that feel, holding that?
Yeah, it's brilliant, unbelievable feeling. All the lads are buzzing in the changing rooms, and I think we deserved it at the end of the day.
It was a very professional performance, wasn't it? I mean, all three playoff games you've played now, the semi-finals and today, you've kept a clean sheet, and I don't think your goalkeeper had to make a meaningful save today.
No, I think throughout the season, like, we've been good defensively as a unit. We've kept a lot of clean sheets this season, not conceded many. And that's credit throughout the team, from the strikers all the way to the keeper. So we did a good job.
Is there a lot of belief amongst this team that you were always going to get to the Championship? Having just missed out on the last day, I mean, you nearly pipped Leeds to that second automatic spot. Did you always believe you could go up through the playoffs?
No, definitely, yeah. Missing out just by a point, I think it hurt us, but we bounced back straight away. Nobody talked about automatic or failing to get automatic promotion. We just kicked on into the playoffs. We were all fully confident, and we've achieved it now.
Let's have a chat with Darren as well, the man who's been right at the heart of keeping those three clean sheets. Absolutely outstanding. I mean, I think you had the joint best defensive record in the division before the playoffs. Three clean sheets in the playoffs. You must be very, very proud.
Yeah, no, we are. As a team, though, you know, it's not just us defenders. It's all round. We've worked extremely hard throughout the season. We really do put the work in to get the clean sheets, and got a just reward today.
You saw the reaction of your fans. I mean, 36-odd thousand that were here today. Absolutely an amazing scene.
Oh, it's brilliant. It's actually superb. I reached the FA Cup final with Millwall when I was there last time, and it was nice scenes there. But, you know, this is just great today to win something and to get this club back into the Championship. It's great.
Can you compete in the Championship? I think you've got about 5 weeks to prepare for it now before you're back for pre-season training. But do you believe that the squad you've got, maybe with one or two additions, can really do a job in the Championship?
Yeah, we've got about 4 weeks, to be fair. But, we have. I feel we have, you know, coming from a Premiership club, you know, looking at differences, that we've got some very good players here. A very, very fit team. I think, you know, again, we run really hard, we worked hard, a lot of energy, and, you know, look forward to seeing what we can do next season.
Did you enjoy it out there, Darren? Or is there too much pressure? Because you were favourites going into the game. Yeah. Does that add the pressure? Can you actually enjoy it on that pitch?
I think, you know, throughout the team, we've got quite a lot of experience, you know, and the manager's had a lot of experience here as well, getting in the finals. So throughout the team, I think, you know, there's a lot of calmness between each other and a lot of talking. So we just enjoyed it, gave our best and got the result.
And, of course, Danny, you weren't part of it last year when the team lost here. Darren wasn't either, so you didn't have the disappointment. But a lot of the other guys in that changing room did. Do they feel as though they've got a monkey off their back now, maybe?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. A lot of the lads are relieved, obviously. They got to the final, like you said, last time, and there were a lot of disappointment. I think they felt how Swindon did today, but this time we've got our just rewards, I think.
Well, well played today, guys. That's Danny Schofield and Darren Wall. Go and enjoy it. We've kept you away from the alcohol for too long. Two very happy faces, and don't they deserve it? Millwall playing in the Championship next season. Danny and Darren, both absolutely delighted.
Thank you, Rob.
After 48 games of a long, arduous season, it all comes down to one more, the biggest of the lot, to decide which of these two teams will be playing in the second tier of English football next season. Swindon are back at Wembley, where they've never lost. Millwall return to the scene and the game of their heartache from just 12 months ago. Craig, the flag is down this time. It's Harris. Schofield wanted it. Harris went for goal. And turned aside by David Lucas. Header from Ward for Millwall. Lovely touch from Harris. Now Schofield. Morrison tried to stay onside, and he has. Steve Morrison goes for the chip. And just over the bar from Millwall's leading goal scorer.
Wow, that's a great bit of improvisation there, wasn't it? Timed his run perfectly. Exquisite little chip. He's very unlucky that.
Here comes Sheehan. Oh, it just needed a touch. There wasn't one. Jean-Francois was the closest to applying one.
Yeah, great. Good quality on the ball from Sheehan. He really whips it in there. You know, never really going to get on the end of that.
Harris. Here's Sean Batt. Useful delivery towards Trotter. An own goal. The flag is up though, and it won't count.
Well, it's actually a very good decision from the linesman, because the Millwall player doesn't actually make contact with it, but he's standing in an offside position. And when it comes in, he scores an own goal.
Swindon yet to have a corner in this game. They have another one to defend. Schofield's delivery all the way through. Peels for handball, and in. Millwall in front.
Wow, this great moment for Millwall. The space he has in the middle of that goal. I mean, it's decent ball in. Goes to him, and look at the time he's got. You wonder there, as it hit his arm, perhaps it's his shoulder. He shouldn't be getting that sort of space.
Sheehan. This is Austin. Tried to go over the central defender. And in the end, Ward was just too big and strong for him.
It is, but it just shows you now, suddenly more belief, passing it around, popping it into space.
A familiar run of Steve Morrison in the channel. Up against Cuthbert, only Harris up with him. It's still Morrison. Cuthbert got back to do just enough.
Well, I mean, again, it's excellent defending, but Morrison's making trouble again. You know, that's the thing, Swindon taking the game to them, runs into the channel. But Cuthbert keeps his eye on the ball, and he's there at the end.
Morrison waits in the penalty area. Schofield once more. In from Harris. Oh, Trotter almost got a touch. Then to Morrison, and away by Cuthbert.
Well, this is Millwall demonstrating that they can play football too. You know, it's good interchange play. Comes in, I mean, it's a good run. He's onside for me there. Keeper does exceptionally well. Two good saves in quick succession.
McGovern's delivery. Flatter one this time. Free header for Jean-Francois and plucked out of the air by Ford.
It's a good save. Gets loads of space. A long way out, though. In the end, it's a fine save from the keeper.
Jean-Francois in ahead of Morrison, helped on by Danny Ward. Oh, the mistake, and this could be the moment. It's Charlie Austin for Swindon Town, and he's missed it. A golden opportunity.
Well, would you believe it? Darren Ward, in solid at the back. Look at this, he just puts it in his path, and off goes Austin, and you think it's just going to be a formality, and then puts it wide. I mean, I'm just wondering whether the ball lifts as he goes to play it, but really he should be hitting the target at the very least there. I think this takes a bobble. Look at this ball just sit up as he goes to hit it.
Morrison again, effortlessly takes it in his stride. Morrison!
He's certainly got some energy, that boy.
Robinson, still his goal that separates the two. But for how much longer? Because Morrison is onside here. It's still Steve Morrison, and still blocked by Lucas, scrambled away. Last minute, last chance saloon for Swindon. Amankwa, it's all about the quality of delivery now. Over Douglas, Austin slipped, blocked, and then the goalkeeper parries and wide for a corner.
Wow, wow, I mean the goalkeeper there, he's flapped at this, it's Austin, he slips, still manages to get something on it, then it just goes through his hands, and he must have thought that's going in the back of the net.
Back in from Derby, but it's to no avail. After four seasons away, Millwall are back in the Championship. And for Kenny Jackett and his team, those horrible memories of 12 months ago are replaced by scenes of sheer joy. So the man who came through Millwall to his system, who scored the all-important goal today, raises the trophy in official confirmation that after four seasons away, Millwall are back in the Championship.
Great crowd here, fantastic support for both clubs. A crowd, I would think, pushing close to 70,000. Which is amazing, really, for the third tier of English football. The prize, of course, is the Championship next season. Okay, this time, good movement from Harris. Well, he goes alone. He had Schofield in acres of space there, Harris. His bat. Trotters in there. It's an own goal! But the flag is up. The flag is up here. It is not going to count. Millwall protest. It won't matter.
And there's the ball laid out. Again, Harris involved, lays it off. And there's the ball coming in. And there, offside. And there's the own goal.
Now Sheehan, almost invited to shoot, and does so.
Well, we've already waxed lyrical about that left foot of his. You can't afford to back off like Millwall did there. And allow him time to go into that space and get it shot away. Look, nobody comes towards him.
There's the corner kick. It goes a long way there, and surely a goal. It is by Robinson. He did it in the semi-final. Now he's done it in the final. And Millwall ahead with one of their longest-serving stalwarts, Paul Robinson.
Well, we said how much longer can they hold out with this sort of pressure? Not very long. This is where they've been strong. That ball's delivered in there. They've won most of the balls in the air. This time, they don't win it, but Robinson's on hand. It was a flick off a Swindon head here. There, doesn't matter. The quality was that good. And Robinson, well, look at this for a finish. There, doesn't come off a Millwall head. He gets a bit of luck, hits his midriff. He's in the right place, right time. Gets luck. That's not luck. Still has to finish it. Finishes it with aplomb, just like a striker, but they deserve it.
Schofield, good run, beaten away by the legs of the goalkeeper, Lucas. Harris again. Once more to Schofield. Harris two. Oh, Trotter was in there. He couldn't get a touch on it. Morrison blocked by Cuthbert. Millwall nearly there with the cushion of a second goal.
There's the ball played in. Goes for the return again. Yeah, not offside. Comes off the goalkeeper. And this time they get a little bit of luck, Swindon. But there's the one again. He's instrumental. Takes up really good positions. And this is a terrific run, isn't it? 5 minutes ago, Pater went for an audacious shot when McGovern was in a lot of space on that right-hand side.
Oh, mistake by Robinson. Austin, big moment here for Swindon. Oh, and he's missed it. Charlie Austin lets Millwall and Paul Robinson in particular off the hook.
Well, they can't believe it, can they? The Swindon fans thought that was one each. And I'm sure the Millwall fans did as well. One mistake, and that's all it takes. He's away with his pace. And you think, well, he's done the right thing. He's not even hit the target. Makes his mind up. Goes for that. He's way, way wide. You have to do better than that. But one-on-one is the most difficult chance to take.
Swindon straining every sinew. A Amankwa. Douglas couldn't get it. Austin! Oh, and the goalkeeper just about. Claws it clear. What a nasty half in the mouth moment for Millwall that was.
Wasn't it just? They back off here. Good first touch. He slips at a vital moment. And look at Ford there. You think that's routine? Nerves. Know how close they are.
But there's still a Swindon corner. What drama here late on. Curled in away by Morrison. It wasn't a great corner. Cut out by the first defender. Almost criminal, really. It's over! Millwall are back in the championship. Last year's heartache turns to joy.
Swindon have missed out on the chance to play championship football next season after a 1-0 defeat to Millwall at Wembley this afternoon. More than 30,000 fans went down to support their team. They couldn't break through their rivals' defences. David Passmore's at Wembley for us now. David, what an afternoon.
Very disappointing, isn't it, Andrew? Swindon's dreams of promotion on the big stage here at Wembley have been dashed. A single goal was enough to condemn them to another season in League One. They played some exciting football this season, scored goals aplenty, but they fell at the final hurdle.
History will record a successful season, but the moment of defeat felt like the end of their world. They failed to produce their best on the big stage, and having come so close, it was hard to take. The players had emerged knowing that the next 90 minutes could define their careers. They also knew goals were likely to be at a premium. Millwall had the early pressure and Swindon an early let-off. Millwall were offside as Kevin Amankwa headed square into his own net. Swindon created little, a shot from Alan Sheehan, a rare chance. Then a corner. The defenders went with the wrong man and Paul Robinson was clear to farm Millwall ahead. Danny Wilson wasn't a happy manager. Swindon were better in the second half, and then the key moment of the game. 20-year-old Charlie Austin had a chance to crown a fairy tale season with an equaliser, but he shot wide. It wasn't the ending the fans had hoped and sung for.
But no, I think the guys were just a bit shell-shocked, really, and they just weren't up for it, but it's a great chance gone missing.
Yeah. We should have had that goal, though. An open goal, but never mind.
You would have backed Charlie, wouldn't you?
I would have, yes, yeah.
Hey, I think Mill would have been a better team for the season, and it's a shame, but, yeah, be back next year, hopefully.
Well, the chairman of Swindon Town has often said promotion is a three-year project. There's 1 year of that to go, so he, the players and the fans will be hoping that next year they're on target. So, on a disappointing night for Swindon, from Wembley, it's back to you.
OK, Dave, thanks very much indeed. And our commiserations to Swindon. I thought they played really well today.
Millwall broke their Wembley hoodoo when they beat Swindon 1-0 to gain promotion to the Championship. The South Londoners, beaten here last year by Scunthorpe, looked to have taken the lead after 28 minutes with an own goal as Kevin Amankwa fired a header into the net. But it didn't count because it was ruled offside. Kenny Jackett's side continued to pressure the Swindon defence. And that paid dividends when defender Paul Robinson scored his seventh of the season. Swindon had never lost at Wembley before today and might blame the controversial Wembley pitch for their defeat when the surface appeared to bobble as Charlie Austin took that shot. There's another chance to see it. There's the bobble. And it came off Austin's shin, much to the dismay of Danny Wilson. Charlie Austin had another chance in the dying minutes, but David Ford blocked it in a heart-stopping moment for the Swindon fans.
Just means the world. I can't describe it. Just so emotional. Such a great day for the club and just so pleased it was me to score, but most importantly, I'm pleased we won the game. That was the biggest thing.
And Steve, for you, coming from non-league in the summer, how special is this moment?
It's an absolute dream. I've been here twice before, but nothing could compare to this. This was an absolute fantastic day and really going to enjoy it. So emotional. And my boat big man steps up, leads. By example, fantastic.
Yeah, you've won here twice with Stevenage. Is this the most special of the three?
That's fantastic. We're getting the championship next year and we're going to show the boys there what we can do there as well.
And Paul, scoring the goal, just done it for Millwall. Having come through the academy as you have, does that make it extra special?
Exactly right. I've grown up here, like I said, and you know, to be the one that scored the goal and you know, for the lads to go down in history, it's a great day for the club. We've put that playoff, you know, burden to bed and now we're looking forward to the championship.
You seemed really business-like, really driven throughout this playoff campaign. How much were you inspired by what happened last year?
I think this year we could cut out the distractions. I think last year, you know, it was a great achievement to get to Wembley and the lads just enjoyed the day. Today, we were in business mode, like you say, we come here to win, and thankfully we did.
I am enormously proud of the squad. We came back a long way from Christmas where things looked pretty bleak, and I think we had a half a year hangover from last year's defeat. And then really, I think it was December 28th, we beat Bristol and took off from there. And I think we lost one or two games since then and led to this. These guys just were determined and didn't let anything get in their way.
As a manager, have you found a real gem in Kenny Jackett?
I think that's pretty obvious that I have had, isn't it?
What about the championship now? That's your next challenge.
I look forward to playing them all. Look forward to the new cities we'll visit. I can't wait. I think we have a very strong squad. I don't think we really have to do that much to it. And I think they're going to perform quite well, and I look forward to next year. And I'm quite confident.
Swindon's dream of playing championship football next season has been shattered after they lost to Millwall in the playoff final. Although it was a tight game, Swindon never really looked like winning. Matthias Kurt watched the game.
Yes, a hugely disappointing afternoon here for 32,000 Swindon fans. Their promotion hopes dashed by Millwall and by their own team, who simply failed to rise to the big occasion. Millwall started the match better and had several good chances early on. David Lucas had to be on his toes. And Swindon thought they'd gone behind when Kevin Amankwa headed the ball into his own net, but it was ruled offside and didn't stand. Then, as half-time approached, Millwall got their breakthrough from a corner. Paul Robinson got to the ball first. Swindon started the second half better, but could have been 2-0 down, but for some fine goalkeeping. Then came Swindon's best chance of the match. Charlie Austin, scorer of 20 goals this season, was clean through on goal, but he shot agonisingly wide, and with that went Swindon's hopes of getting back into the match. Instead, it's back down the M4 and back to the drawing board for another season at least.
Young Charlie, because he's taken it to heart, and it's not down to him. It's not down to him at all. It's possibly down to him we're here, you know, in the first place. So that's a fantastic season he's had.
The club earned about £500,000 from their Wembley adventure, but they missed out on the £4 million that playing in the Championship would have brought.
We're a much better place than we were a couple of years ago. You know, we've got a lot of strength now and we've got a great spine to the squad.
Tomorrow it's the club's end-of-season awards dinner. Much will rightly be made of a successful season. It's hard to balance that against a Wembley defeat. David Passmore, BBC Points West.
Out of Wembley, where Millwall will be playing Championship football for the first time in 4 years next season, Kenny Jackett's side beat Swindon 1-0 in the League One playoff final. Once again, though, there was controversy over the state of the Wembley pitch.
Millwall's Championship hopes went up in smoke at Wembley last year, so they started this time around full of determination not to repeat the experience. This chip from Steve Morrison, one of several early Millwall chances. Then, after half an hour, offside was the verdict before Kevin Amankwa headed into his own net. Then Millwall did score. A Danny Schofield corner finished from close range by Paul Robinson.
He's in the right place, right time. Gets luck. That's not luck. Still has to finish it.
Halfway through the second half, Swindon looks certain to equalise.
Oh, mistake by Robinson. Austin, big moment here for Swindon. Oh, and he's missed it.
They couldn't believe it, neither could he, but did the much maligned Wembley pitch play a part?
Makes his mind up, and there, look at that, just jump up, and it does hit his shin.
Morrison could have eased Millwall's tension with 8 minutes to go. Then with 30 seconds to go, Swindon had the final chance of the game.
Austin! Oh, the goalkeeper just about! Millwall are promoted!
Millwall at last win a playoff. It's the Championship for them, and the last 15 sides promoted via the playoffs have stayed up. Gary Cottrell, Sky Sports.
Great win for us, we did fantastic.
Did you come here today with unfinished business?
Yeah, definitely. We've had a good couple of seasons, you know, very good, so it's great to finish it off this way. I'm really pleased for everybody at the club, it's been an excellent decision to push on this year, and, you know, we've consciously made it, but now we've got to enjoy this. Look forward quickly, because we want to go in the next league and compete.
Had one or two little anxious moments right at the end there, didn't you?
Yeah, fair play to Swindon. Particularly at the start of the second half, they played really well and came at us. The keeper was strong on one or two crosses when he needed to be, but great feeling.
How proud are you to be the manager of the first Millwall team to come here to Wembley and win?
Yeah, they've been hitting us with that. I don't think we've been very good in playoff games so far, so if you keep persevering, you get there.
And how fitting is it that it should be Paul Robinson, of all people, to get the goal?
Yeah, good goal and big contribution. Been a really good player for us this year.
You've never managed in the Championship. How much are you looking forward to that challenge?
I've got to say, I've worked hard for it, so I'm looking forward to it, I really am.
No more than Millwall deserve this, is it, really?
Definitely. We've had a good couple of years, and finishing third, you know, it's justice done.
Neil, you're cold and wet. How do you feel?
Oh, over the moon. With the motivation of losing last year, all year, that has been our driving force. And today, we put it right.
Well, when you think back to the dressing room last year, and then take a look over your shoulder, what does it mean?
Firstly, what a great bunch of boys we got here. You know, we're so lucky as a club, the manager's so lucky to have a bunch of boys who get on so well, enjoy each other's company on and off the pitch. We play for each other, we play for the club. And, you know, the fans at this club, they're extremely proud of us because they know they've got a bunch of boys who enjoy wearing the shirt.
What was the feeling like then when you lifted that playoff trophy? Yeah.
I was starting to think it was never going to happen, lifting the trophy. But, you know, got there in the end.
You know, they're the first half, we've had the second half. It's just gone between us missing the header from the corner and a bobble on Charlie when he goes through on the keeper. So it's really hinged on those two moments, I suppose.
That was the key moment for you in the second half, wasn't it? Charlie Austin's effort. And were you aware of the bobble at the time?
You could see straight away, yeah. I've not seen it yet on TV, but I presume it was. It looked like it just bobbled up on him, you know, and I feel gutted for young Charlie because he's taken it to heart, and it's not down to him. It's not down to him at all. It's possibly down to him we're here, you know, in the first place. So that's a fantastic season he's had. Yeah, but what I say, when you get here, you try and finish it off, and unfortunately we've not done it today.
More from Wembley throughout the hour, including the Swindon chairman who blames the Wembley pitch for this miss and now wants the playoffs moved.
Never wanted to jump on the pitch bandwagon, but, you know, the county ground's a better pitch than this, by some margin. You know, early in the game, I was very aware, and we all were, that the ball was holding up on the pitch. It doesn't run. You know, you've got players who are selling passes short, not because they're not good players, but because it just stops. I couldn't decide whether the grass was too long. You know, it's very difficult to understand what's going on, really. So, in that sense, I am jumping on the bandwagon, but that's not a reason, you know. We were beaten, and I'm putting my hand up saying we were beaten. But this pitch has got to get better, and the sooner we move this lot to the Millennium Stadium, the better, frankly.
Swindon Town are still coming to terms with the reality of another season in League One after losing to Millwall in the playoff final at Wembley. As is so often the case, the margin between success and failure was slight, but the London side edged to victory in front of nearly 75,000 fans. Perhaps the players were guilty of resting on those laurels in the first half, as Millwall created chance after chance. Swindon posed no threat other than to themselves. Kevin Amankwa headed into his own net, but his blushes were spared by the linesman. But Millwall sensed vulnerability and eventually got what they deserved. Paul Robinson pounced on a poorly defended corner. This was not part of the plan, and Swindon's manager Danny Wilson made his feelings clear. His team responded in the second half and then had this fantastic opportunity.
Austin, big moment here for Swindon! Missed it. Charlie Austin.
On closer inspection, an ill-fated bobble of the ball was to blame. With that, went Swindon's hopes of promotion.
I put my house on to score, but it's everybody. It's unfortunate he's got a bobble. You cannot legislate for that. And we're not going to give any criticism out to Charlie because of it.
Now Swindon will have to pick themselves up and go again in League One next season.